Okay, welcome back. Sorry for this inconvenience. We have a technical problem today. The temperature is very high. Also, the temperature in the field, as you can see, now, wow, great, great play by the defense, by the leaders of the French team.
11 on the man, right there.
Yeah.
Everybody was on the tackle.
The defense read very well the game, and it means that now the Finland has 4 and 7, so basically they were going to punt the first punt of the game. So the first drive of the Finnish team is that starts very well. It will close with a punt. No more than a punt. It's a good punt.
It's a good one, yeah.
Ooh,
very risky right there.
Yeah.
But yeah, they were moving the chain really fast with their passes, but the defense adjusted really quickly. So
basically, nothing for Finland today. For now, the French is entering with leading by the number 5. Colombo Matteo. Now
Matteo,
they will start
yep.
from the 48 yards in their own field.
Let's see what Matteo has.
There's a huge motion.
Wow, never seen anything like this lately.
It's a run.
Woo!
Wow, the number 30.
The running back is going.
15-yard rush by the number.
Number 20.
By the number 20 or 30, Keita Redba.
Ervan Jandrik.
No, it was the number 30, I guess.
Oh. Oh yeah,
Keita,
it's number
30. Redval is a very interesting run, and now they are in the Finland territory from the 36-yard. We have another high formation.
Ooh,
oh, the snap was
very
not
risky.
Good. Colombo was not ready to receive the snap, and basically they lost 1 yard for. 2 yards actually, and now it will be a second and 12 in the Finland territory. So after the first run by
they
the French team,
the
Finnish defense basically set it up, and now they bring the back for a little bit for a couple of yards. The
they
French
have to recover from the fumble. So
wow.
I would have expected a pass.
Yeah, it's a
they tried with the sweep, but it didn't work. So
Leo
good
Gaben,
job for the defense.
Leo Gaben, he was the one that ran for approximately 3 yards, and 2 yards actually, and now is a 3rd and 10. So now we will see what Matteo Colombo will decide to play. They are in a huddle.
They're changing a couple players, so I guess it's going to be a big pass. That's what I would do, at least.
Yeah.
There you go. Mathieu is ready with all his receivers out.
Okay, but timeout.
Of course.
Yeah, probably the French team has to. The French team has to think a little bit more about what kind of play they have to execute right now.
Yeah.
Because you know, we have also to consider that we are on the 36 yards. So even if you can gain 5 yards with a small run, you can also have your kicker ready for
yes.
a 3-point game. So now
I saw the defense from Finland very ready to wait for a run, though. Like, even the fumble was because they dominated on the line. So I think they're going to go with a pass, but who knows? Maybe they're going to surprise us with a trick play or something.
What actually we saw right now was exactly the head coach from Finland, from Finnish team, told us about how the defense
is
very strong.
Very strong on the line. 77 is ready. He's on his feet really quick. For any rush moves.
So we have 4 men on the defense.
Another
ready.
Motion, so it can be a run, a big run from the fullback.
Let's
number
see.
40. And it's a pass.
So, Matteo Colombo, let's see. It's a sack.
And it's a sack.
Oh, wow.
And it's a fumble or not? No, it's
no,
not.
No, it was already on the field, but El Carti Elias from Finnish team sank.
What a sack.
What a sack with a loss of 20 yards.
We were expecting that from Finland, didn't we?
Well, what a play from the Finnish defense. And now it's a fourth and super long.
So it's a super punt.
It's super punt. Let's see, ready for the punt is the number 23, Chevalier Clement, that is also the kicker. The punt is not a very good punt. They're out of the field. So these first two drives, one from Finnish and one from French, told us basically that the game will be very interesting and dominated by the defense. Because
yes.
What we saw right now is the capability of the both quarterbacks
to put
the ball in the air.
Yep.
But the defense for the both team are very strong and ready.
It's going to be a defensive battle for sure. Let's see what they got. Phelan is ready.
Phelan
and
is ready.
It's another pass right away.
It's an incomplete pass.
I want to see a little bit of Phelan's running back running a little bit.
Yeah.
It's funny how they start with a pass. Like, as I've seen in Europe, it's not a very,
it's very
common tendency. Yeah.
But don't forget that the Finnish team has a long history about football, and they dominated in the last years the European Championship for three times in a row. And so they have a good school, but now...
Almost intercepted by France.
Yeah, Triboulet was very close to make the first interception of the game.
So we like Finland's experience, but I think we need some power football right there to go through.
Yeah, it's a third down and 10. So let's see what's going on right now. We have Jerry Byman ready for
another
long pass. The number is pressed.
Almost intercepted.
It's another incomplete. Very lucky throw this time from Byman because the line was close and he basically threw the ball without looking for any wide receiver, but was just because under pressure.
And the Finland is gonna punt again. So we have seen a lot of footballs in the air, the defensive cornerbacks. The cornerbacks of France are very, very, very strong and very quick. So I think they're very emotional in this moment. That's why they didn't intercept the ball, but they are capable of it, and we're going to see a lot of it.
Do not forget that we are talking about guys from 17 to 90 years here. So the playing maybe for their first international championship.
Exactly.
And,
so
I can
their hands shake a little bit.
Yeah, for true. So, Colomb back in the field.
Riding the wave.
Let's see.
If they're going to motion again with all their players. Nope.
Okay, weak formation.
And the motion.
It's a fake, but it's a run.
End around.
Wow. With
a nice end around run.
Tackle for loss from the Finnish defense. 2-yard loss. By the number 28 of the French team, that is
Meunier-Paul.
Meunier-Paul, the first run of the game was not a good run because he lost 2 yards. Well, actually 1 yard. So now it's a second and 11. Let's see.
Flag.
Probably a 4-star. Let's see what the
false start by the offense, number 89, 5-yard penalty, second down.
Okay, for all of our friends that is following us today and maybe they do not know exactly all the game rule about the American football, what happened? A flag has been thrown, the flag is the yellow flag that has been thrown by the crew, the referee crew, and it means that someone in the offensive line of the French team make a movement before the snap.
Man.
Wow.
When you make all these motions, this is a big risk you encounter. A lot of flags because not everybody is in sync, and it makes you lose a lot of yards. So we're going to see what they're going to put on the table now.
Full start. Offense, number 30, so 5-yard penalty, second down.
So when you receive a full start flag, you lost 5 yards. Now French receive two full stars flag in a row, and it means that now they have to complete 10 yards more to close the down. So basically now they have a 2nd and 20 to complete the down and keep the ball. It's another run.
Another run.
Wow.
Montauban Candy.
Keita Redva try to run, but as you can see, Nausicaa, the Finnish defense is always ready, and they are able to understand the play. And as you can see, they also go in 5 or 6 to tackle the runner.
Yeah. They adapted really, really quickly to the French power football game. They're running the ball a lot. I think that it's time for a pass, but we'll see what Mathieu decides to do.
Yeah, the secondary for the Finnish defense is always very, very close to the defensive line. And now let's see if what column. Wow. There's another incomplete pass.
It could have been a nice play, but the French machine isn't oiled enough yet. So we're trying to understand if they have to adjust and be better. In the third drive they're gonna play.
Anyway, another punt. It confirmed that this is a punt, a super punt game, and it means that the defense are playing very, very well.
They are
for
definitely
this
dominating.
First quarter. Oh, another. Not very good punt. The Finnish team will start directly from the French territory on the 47-yard, I guess, for this first down. And this is the first time that the Finnish team is entered into the French territory. So let's see what's going on.
Let's see if they're going to keep their strategy of their passing game or if they're going to surprise us with a run.
Bayman in the pocket. The snap is good.
Ooh, a little option right there. Nice run by number four,
Nico Barrow. He ran for 5 yards.
He broke a tackle and kept going. We like this power football from Finland. It's a nice game.
So if the Finnish team starts to be very productive also in the run game, it will be a nightmare for the French team.
Yeah. So I like the strategy of the Finnish team that tried to spread the offense, the defense, sorry.
Yeah.
And now they're trying to run the ball.
Be honest, the Finnish team is showing us a lot of option games. Now let's see Bayman.
Another option on the other side.
The other side. Good tackle by the number 53, Zentric Erwan.
Another pretty good game.
Gain a couple of yards, so now we have a second and four and third and four, I guess. Third and four, so it means that the Finnish team has to complete 4 yards to keep the down marker to one and starts again with another four tentatives and keep the ball.
Oh, nice. Incredible
job.
Play from the defense.
Good job by the French defense. The number 58 basically broke the offensive line and enter
Umberto Onart.
Very close to Sank Baiman. Baiman was very irred at the situation.
He wasn't expecting that for sure. Fourth down.
Oh, they play the four. Okay, it's a 4-4, and then they decide to play.
And
it's a run. It's a run, but yeah. Now. Okay.
Should have used the option, but it didn't work. So.
Yeah, I think that they basically didn't find any option, or probably Baiman in this case want to show also to the defense, to the French defense. How strong
play
is.
Clock is not working, therefore we will be going to an on-field play clock.
And but the defense of the French team was ready, and now they will start from the 40 yards.
It's another run by the fullback number 40, Tamer Iliam. Very strong fullback, very fast and powerful. I like this run. You're starting with the right feet.
And we have to say that now French team changed the quarterback. Matteo Colomba is on the sideline, and now the quarterback in the field is Leo Cremades. So it's fun. You know, sometimes the quarterback is the most valuable player in a team, and you bet on the quarterback about the strategy of your team.
Another sweep for them. Wow.
There's another run.
Nice.
Wow.
Gain. Number 34, Bernier Jonas.
What a run.
What a run
for more than 10 yards. And even after the first tackle, he continued to run and gain another 3-4 yards. So it's a huge and powerful run made by the French team. And now we are entering into the Finland territory. This is a first and 10 on the. And even if the French team change the quarterback, they still continue to make run games.
Yeah, but well, it's good because they don't give a key to the defense to read anything. They're just keeping their game going. And I like number 34. His speed and his explosiveness is incredible.
Yeah, definitely. But let's see now what's going on.
So we.
I don't know what's going on actually right now. There's.
But if everybody wants, anybody is interested, Austria is winning 13-0 to Spain.
No, okay. We're just.
And it's another run by 34.
Wow. 4-yard run. And now we are on the 36 yard for the 2nd and 6.
Very nice speed by 34. He is definitely leading the way of this offense, and incredible blocks by his teammates. So we're gonna see how this goes. If with their powerful ball, they're gonna be able to come through.
Actually, I don't know if now the offensive line of French has increased their powerful, or the defense by the Finnish team has decreased a little bit more. But now the French is doing an amazing job, and is always the number 34.
And it's again Pernier Jonas, the running back of the French team. Incredible speed by Pernier.
Yeah. He's doing a very good job, and he's moving the chain just by himself. And now we are on the 25 yards in the Finnish territory.
He is finding the holes in the defense in a very, very creative way. I like this running back. Let's see what he got again here.
Just one receiver on the left. But it's another run.
Number 30. Whoa. Going through the defense.
Okay.
So it's Montauban Kendi again.
And it's a 5-yard rush.
Not bad.
So step by step, run by run, the French team. They're
finding a way to come through. I think it's very important, though, to dose a little bit of run, a little bit of pass, just to don't make your players die under this heat.
Yeah.
But we're going to see what number six has in store.
And all of these runs gave also to the French team the confidence, and they are feel more, you know.
More at ease, yes.
Yeah, more at ease, yeah, definitely.
Number 40 again is running through the defense. Not a big gain for Tamer Iliam.
And the defense of the Finnish of the Finland team started to get a little bit scared about what's going on. In fact, even the effectiveness of their tackle are not more, powerful and in time. And it allows the French team always to collect and gain some yards. And now we are on the 3-3 on the 18 yards. So let's see what the French team wants to play. There's always a running back in the backfield. There's a fullback, the number 34. And this is another timeout. Timeout.
Number 34, Laib Cyril. Ready.
Timeout by the offense. Second timeout.
Okay, this is the second timeout, and basically the French team used the two timeouts of their three timeouts that they have in this first quarter. So it means that basically in this first half of the game it remains just one timeout. Call, but probably the head coach of the French thinks that it's important now to make another with their player, with this player, and transfer all the messages that he thinks are valuable in order to gain these three last yards to close the down.
It's a very important moment in the game right now because they can unlock their state of mind and everything that is going to come after this. This can give them hope or it can destroy them. So let's see what happens and what number 34 is in store, number 6 for us in this offense.
So what do you bet, Nausicaa? Run or pass?
I think it's going to be a run by number 34 because they are really confident.
Too easy.
Or a trick play.
Oh. You say trick play?
Like number 6 has to be on field for a reason. And maybe it's because he has a really good thrower.
Let's see, is another run. But no, wow.
That was super predictable, definitely.
Number 79.
So it's the fourth down. It's going to be...
The number 79, Otto Mäkinen, he basically break through the offensive line and take... Let's see, it's a 4-4, actually, and they're going to play. I would do the same, actually.
I would do exactly the same.
But probably this means that the kicker is not good enough to cover all this distance with the kick.
Ooh.
Number 20. No good. Okay.
Tried with every inch of his body to come through, but it couldn't go.
Okay, they tried to close the down with another run. I lose the count of how many runs the French team played, but anyway, the result is a turnover. So the ball come back to the Finnish team.
Now we accept some bets from our viewers. How are they going to start? Are they going to start with a pass? Or with a run. For the Finnish tradition, probably a pass to confuse the defense.
Yeah, true. But anyway, in this case, what we are collecting from this first quarter is that the Finnish team on the offensive side is able to manage both the games, the the pass and the run. On the other end, the French is more very effective with the run games.
Exactly.
And in the medium-long term, this could affect the results of the game.
Number four, Nico Barro just carried the ball for at least...
Eight yards.
8 yards. A very good run now to move the chain and be able to gain that.
That's the end of the first quarter.
And now this is the end of the first quarter. It means that the team is changing the field, and we will start from the on the other end, on the other side of the field, from the 22 yards, and there will be a second and third for the Finnish team.
Very interesting when this switch happens, because you have to reset again, and it's almost like a resetting of all the minds. Everybody has to come back in position, and you think about the next move. It's a really interesting moment for me as a player when I change sides. So I think it's the same for them.
Yeah, for sure.
They started with some runs finally. The Finnish team is really surprising us. Let's see what they got.
So let's see, we have the number seven of the Finnish team, Jere Baiman, ready to start the game. In the backfield, we have the number four, the running back, Nico Barro. We have, well, actually four receivers ready, two on the left and two on the right.
Nice.
So, lot of option for Jere Baiman.
And also the little protection of number four for him, so he can feel safe.
Let's see, Nico Barro, very close to Jere Baiman. It's a pass.
Wow. Wow. Flat by flat. 91 from France. An incredible,
Coco Ive. Coco Ive.
Emmanuel Iri. He has a lot of names, and he's also a very good player. It's the second time he does this.
He deflected the ball. So basically it was no gain from the Finnish team, and there is a third and three. So let's see, another four receiver ready to take the pass. Is another
pass again, but France is very, very strong in deflecting all these balls. Incredible.
So the target was Jakob Panaman, but
Jonas was stronger, let's say.
And the result is an incomplete pass. And the Finnish team is going to punt. So we have the number one ready to punt, Alexis Pulkkinen.
It's interesting because the Finland team always starts really well.
It's a good punt. Let's see the kick, the punt return, the number 18, but there's a flag. What, another flag, full of flag.
And it was number 16.
Okay. Elia Kramé was the punt returner, but we have three flags on the field. Probably we have some holding from the returning from the kicking team. Let's see
what happens here.
Let's see. Sometimes in this case we have holding
on both sides, but I think it's only on the French side.
There's multiple fouls on the play. We have a holding on the return team number 24. That penalty is declined. Illegal block in the back, return team number 10. This penalty will be 10 yards, first down.
Okay, so two fouls on the field. One was the holding, the other one was an illegal block in the back. And
guys, is it post?
The result is 10-yard penalties, and it means that the French team
will start
10 yards behind where they take the ball from the punt. It's a bad situation because Elia made a good return,
broke up a couple tackles. So I think that we're gonna start with a run again. for the French team. They try to impose their running game.
So, Leo Cremades, quarterback, is another run. Wow.
Another run by 34. I think that the defense from the Finnish team is trying to stop 34 right there. So now they're spying on him. And
yeah, now they understand how he played.
So Laib Cyril is not going to have an easy game from now on.
No, it took a couple of drives for the Finnish defense to set properly.
Yep.
But now, since that we were back at the beginning of the quarter, the first quarter, where the Finnish defense was very...
Another
okay, probably is an encroachment.
Offside.
Yeah.
Encroachment.
So this will be
Let's
a
see
flag
what the
against
say.
The Finnish defense. The crew.
Illegal snap. Offense number 75. 5-yard penalty. Still second round.
Okay.
That's the bad news for the French team.
So, was a gain of 3 yards with the previous rush, but now with this flag, with these penalties, we will back on the second and 12. So the offensive line made a fall. Okay. Let's see. As you can hear, the supporter of French is...
The French is insisting with the running game.
Yeah.
The running game, number 30.
Maybe I'm wrong, but the effectiveness of running game by French team is reducing dramatically play after play.
Yes, definitely. I mean, if you... wear out your players, making them run all the time, and it's always the same players and it's always the same fakes. The defense just understands really quickly the game and is able to stop you super fast. So
yeah, and even if you can broke at the first tackle, as you can see, the secondary line is very close, so that you cannot gain a lot of yards from your run. Okay,
another
flag,
start.
Another full start by French team. So another 5-yard penalty.
Full start by the offense, number 80. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Okay, if I'm not wrong, the French team collect approximately 50-yard penalties today.
That's too many yards.
Yeah, it's offside.
Especially for this little mistake.
Yeah.
You know, you need some discipline on the field. The discipline really, really helps you in these cases.
And now is a third and 14. Is another motion. Okay, it's a
pass
game
for 88.
86. It's a good. It's a complete pass.
86. Yeah.
So what? The 86 is Ait Saidi Jenemi. Nice game.
But it's not enough.
But it's not enough. So good to see that the French team has also some pass game in their options. But he collect just 5 yards or 6 yards, no more than that. So now it's a 4-6. And they are going to punt.
It's another
punt. Not a very interesting punt.
Not very successful.
No. And the Finnish team has the opportunity to start directly from the French in the French territory
here
on the 40 on the 44 yards. And 42 yards. So the temperature here in Bologna today is very hot.
Very hot
is the temperature that we have here on the Bettina Gamberini field with the supporters of both teams that are encouraging their team on the field. Let's see now the Finnish team ready to start the offensive play.
And it's Weimann. A pass again.
It's a pass. It's a good pass.
82.
And now, and probably is a complete.
By Joel.
Let's see.
Cerquela.
Let's see, it's a complete. The chain is moving. Good play from the Finnish team. Weimann for the number 82.
Joel
Cerquela. It was one game, one play, and one down completed. So interesting play made by the Finland team. Weimann, we are with four receiver. Another pass game, another, no, was an incomplete. The target was the number 83.
And it was stopped by number 8, one of the players that the coaches of the French team
appointed as exactly. One of the best players.
So it's Beregret Maceo. The cornerbacks of the French team are really quick. I like them. They're going to be instrumental here to stop Finland from scoring.
Yeah, probably is the only way that to stop this passing game
exactly.
From the Finland team. That because Weimann is very precise in his throw, so I like his way to throw the ball in the air, and it's very precise. Whoa! Let's see.
Wow! Nice reaction by the defensive line of the French team.
True. No gain on this. No game on this play.
But Weimann took a really hard hit right there. He seems a little confused too.
Let's see what's going on because Weimann took a very, very strong tackle. So it's a third and 11. Lost one. Finnish team lost 1 yard in the previous play. Always the same formation from the Finland team. Four receiver, one running back. Weimann.
It's another pass.
Wow, it's a complete pass.
A little bobbling, but it's a
not enough.
Pass by 81.
Not enough to close the down.
Christian Natunen.
But it's a 4-3. 4-3, let's see. It's going to play. They're going to play. They're trying to close the down. Now we have two receiver on the left, one on the right, and one on the left.
I expect a little pass or a little option from the running back.
Let's see, it's another pass. It is an incomplete pass. Probably, you know, is that when you are 3 yards to close down, probably the run game could be a good option.
I think they didn't have the formation for it. The running back was in a position where it could have received the pitch like right away for an option or an end off, but they don't seem to use end offs really often, so
yeah.
We'll see what happens here for France, who's starting in a good position.
So
overall.
For now we can say for our friends that you're following us, French is more a running game
yep,
team and instead Finnish.
Absolutely.
Number
34 is running again in the middle. Cyril is really trying to come through.
And he just gained 1 yard, so it's a second and 9. I told you, running game is no more productive than in the beginning of the game.
Yeah, at the beginning they weren't expecting it, but now it's definitely... Definitely going a little worse for them.
Okay, so it's a second and 9, another run. And now
number
in the fullback, wow.
Is going.
It's very good.
Very good. Wow. Very good run from number 26 of France, Bacanti Polan Yanis. Incredible run, incredible speed that will allow France to start again for a first down.
I love this
game
because I was just saying that the running effectiveness was not
bad.
was reducing dramatically, and now the French run for more than 20 yards.
The 26 is fresh though. He has some breath now. So
let's see, it's another run. But now the number 26 is just a collect just 1 yard. So it's a second and 9 probably.
It's hard for a running back to do a back-to-back run like this fast.
Yeah.
So I think they have to give their running backs a little rest before they can run again like that.
Anyway, the French team has a lot of options as a running back. We have, if I'm looking at the roster.
Number 40, number 34. Yeah. Number 44 is resting now, thank God. Ooh, a nice motion. And it's number 26 again. Yanis is running the ball. It's a pretty good gain, actually.
It's a five-yard gain. So we will have 3 yards and three, I guess, on four.
Bacanti Polin is leading
okay.
the way here.
Matteo Colomb is back on the field.
Yeah, he's back.
And now he's leading a drive, a very interesting drive from French. They are in the Finnish territory. Is another run.
Another run by Bacanti Polin Yanis.
But no gain this time.
But no gain. It's the fourth down. They're going to punt.
We have an injury on the field. The number 79 from the Finland team is Otto Mäkinen.
He's a very, very good player. Very good player of their defensive
line. Yeah, he's like 6 foot tall, is 130 kilos, and from Porvoo Butchers.
But he's walking out of the field, so good job.
Okay, I was just...
Okay, so...
So we have a 4-4.
And they're going to punt. Another punt for France.
Oh, the snap, a very high snap. But now the punt is good. It's an interesting punt.
Fair catch from number 15 from Finland. They're going to start.
Fair
in
catch.
A good, I mean, pretty good position. Not too bad, not too good.
No, but this time the punt was better.
Definitely.
Yeah.
He had less yards to make, and he did an effective punt.
If you consider also that he received a very high snap, so he lost a few seconds just to take the ball, take the ball and adjust it.
Let's see what Finland has in store for us. I'm expecting a pass from the trips on the right.
Byman in the pocket. Three wide receiver on the right, one on the left, one running back.
And it's
another
pass on the trips.
In the middle of nothing, in the middle of nowhere. First time that I see Byman throw the ball without any target.
You know, there was a big penetration and from the defensive line of France. He couldn't see anything, so I think he just threw.
Yeah,
like
probably he wanted just to avoid another hit.
Or another sack, yeah.
Same formation of the previous play.
It's a trips right, and we're going to see if he's going to hit the trips or the security receiver on the other side. But it's a trips again for number 88. Great catch, but not a lot of yards.
It's just 2 yards or 3 yard gain. So we have a third and 7.
The cornerbacks are really fast. They were being stopped by the other two receivers trying to block for 88, but they couldn't. So they're really, really fast.
So it's a 3rd and 6. Let's see, Byman.
This time it's a trips on the left.
Yep.
And it's another pass for the trips, number 10 this time.
It's a complete pass, but not enough to close the down.
So it was Kim Serjavi. Kim Serjavi.
Probably is 4-1.
First down. It's actually a first down.
Wow. It's a first down.
It's a first down, so
be
Finland
honest.
Is moving the chain. And
wow. Be honest.
This
trip
is working.
I thought it was very close to close the down, but was not successful. Instead, the Finnish team closed the down And the counter starts from the beginning, so it's a first and 10.
They're changing formation, now it's a balanced formation, two receivers on each side. We will see how the defensive side of the ball will adjust to this.
It's flag.
It's raining flags. It's hallelujah. So...
Okay, lot of love in the field because we have several holdings from the offense. It's a full start. I missed the full start.
Full start.
So basically 5 yards. Let's see.
Illegal formation, more than 4 men in the backfield by the offense. Okay. The penalty will be declined.
Illegal formation.
Okay, illegal formation.
There were 4 men in the backfield. Shouldn't have. So, second down for Phelan.
You know, sometimes when the ref called this illegal formation, it's just because sometimes they're not very aware about what kind of information the team is going to put in the field.
Yeah.
You know, especially when you try to use some very interesting formation, not so common, they receive this kind of flag. But the result is that you have to come back for 5 yards and then let's do it
and
again.
It's a run this time. But this was a bad read by the quarterback. The defensive end number 91 was penetrating the line.
Yeah,
and
it was already in the backfield.
Yep. He was supposed to keep it, but he just gave it away. I think this quarterback is really concerned by the hits, and he's trying to be as efficient as he can. Okay.
Anyway, so it's a third and super long.
The receivers are very narrow now. They weren't wide. Let's see.
It's an incomplete pass. So my point of view about Bayman is a good quarterback, but when he has to play some games outside the scheme.
There's a 2 minute warning.
He's not able to manage the stress of the situation.
Yeah.
As you can see now, he has to run, he has to pass running, and the pass was not, the accuracy was not so good.
I haven't seen him running since the game started, and I think it would have helped, but I think he is a quarterback that is a little bit afraid of being hit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
One of those quarterbacks. There's nothing wrong with it, but they're just a different kind.
Nice job by the special team of the Finnish team.
Yeah, number 16 from France received the ball but couldn't go through.
Yeah, the number 28 by Finland did a good job during this special team play. The number 28 is Heetu Jokinen. And now
but
the
they're
ball
starting from a good spot overall.
Yeah, absolutely. They are in the 45 yards in the French territory.
Let's see what Matteo has in store for us. Number 30
is
was
a
ready
pass.
For a run, but it's a pass.
It's a complete pass. For a 5 yard gain.
Number 86.
What? Nice play. Colombo was under pressure by the pass rusher of the Finnish team, but he was able to make a good throw and complete this play with a 5 yard gain. Colomb, another pass.
This pass wasn't precise enough, but
no.
I think it was.
But there's a flag.
Oh.
There's a flag.
It's really hard to throw on the opposite side of your arm or your throwing arm, so I think you just was a little bit unbalanced.
Let's see what the ref is calling with this flag.
DPI. Prior to the pass, holding by the defense, number 20.
Okay.
It's a 10-yard penalty and automatic first down.
Okay, so we have an holding for the defense, and it cost 10 yards for against the defense, and it means the first down from France. So, nice gift.
Lucky
gift. Yeah. Nice gift in this second quarter, and with this flag, the French team enter into the Finland territory.
Little sweep for number 26 of France.
It's a short run. 3 yards run.
Not enough for a sweep for Bakanti Polanyanis.
And now the French team is running fast because they do not have any more timeout. Probably they have just one timeout left.
They're trying to do everything really fast. This passing game isn't synchronized enough.
No.
The receiver was making signs to the quarterback, but they didn't understand each other, so this happened.
Anyway, as you can see, now the French team use 2 of 3 timeouts in the first quarter, and now that they are in very good position in the field, they need maybe sometimes you can need timeout, but you do not have timeout, and they have to run because the clock is ticking, and sometimes happen what we saw. So very under pressure, you are not so precise in your play.
Another sweep for the French team.
Oh, it's a fumble! Fumble recovered by Finland.
That's not what France needed right now.
No.
It can happen. I don't understand the use of sweeps that much right now, because the defense is very, very powerful in the line for the Finnish team, and they can block a sweep like that.
A nightmare for the offensive line of the French team, because they were in a good position, but with this fumble, they basically lost their opportunity for now to go into score, because the ball is back and the Finnish team ends with Baiman ready in the field pocket.
Big throw, but not precise enough.
And the pass is incomplete. So we will see a second and 10.
The cornerbacks of France don't give any break to the Finnish receivers. It's incredible. Do we have a balanced formation?
Lucky you have this kind of cornerbacks, because with this passing game from the Finnish team will be a suicide.
Another incomplete pass for Finland. 82 dropped a pass that was really hard to receive. So they are trying. They're trying with their passes, but they can't come through. It's a third and 10 again.
So, 3 receiver on the right, Baiman is counting, take the ball.
Another pass for the trips, and we see him running for the first time.
But this is another incomplete
pass.
So, it's a 4, we will see a 4 and 10, probably a punt.
It's a game of defenses.
Yeah. We said it at the beginning of the game.
You know that for national teams, it's really hard to sync their offenses compared to the defenses. Every national team has a really hard time to sync, because they don't practice that much as a regular a regular franchise. So it's really hard for them to play all together. They're from all different teams across the country, so it's hard. Ooh, bad snap.
Almost
recovered by France. But they will start with a very, very good spot.
Yeah. Anyway.
It's now or never.
I totally agree with you regarding how it's difficult to set the offensive schemes and teams. But looking at the roster from the French team, I saw a lot of players comes from one or two teams in France. So basically, I think that some plays are already embedded into their minds because they
That's
spent
true.
All the season together.
That's true. But it's still time hard, out. You know.
By the defense, first time out.
A team is made with 11 players, and even if you switch one of them,
for sure.
It changes everything. So I think that's why on the first half of every game in international games and national teams, you see these offenses trying to adjust and try to find a way to play together.
Yeah, I agree. You could be lucky if you have the same quarterback and wide receiver, especially in the pass game. But if you don't, it's very difficult.
It's also hard with the blocking part of it, especially for the
with
backs.
The center, for the snap.
And for the snap, yeah, for sure. So it's really hard for them to sync, but I think that we're going to see big, big plays during the third and fourth quarter of this game. So France is starting with a super, super spot with number six. The quarterback number six is going to be on the field today.
Okay, we can say that now the French is in a field goal range.
Yeah,
okay?
Basically, so yeah.
Basically, we are in the field goal range.
So Cremad Leo and number 26 have to show us what they got. But it's a pass from Cremad Leo that's trying to escape.
It's an
interception for Finland.
Wow.
That's not what they needed.
What's going
but
on?
But the referee is not. Doesn't
there's
agree.
A flag. There's a flag. Probably. Interception. Pass interference.
By the way, the interception was from number 28.
The result of the play is the first down wide. After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, wide number 28, have the distance to the goal, first down.
Okay.
It's still going to be a first down for
So it was
Finland.
An unsportsmanlike conduct by the number 28 that was the player that made the interception.
He showed his number as Superman, but honestly...
Like Cam Newton.
But I love this kind of things. I think they're really express the emotion of these players on the field, and they shouldn't be forbidden. But a rule is a rule. So
I totally agree with you.
But yeah, so I appreciate it. Actually, it's really funny.
Anyway, so what we saw.
First down.
And after this. After the punt we saw before from the Finnish team, now they take back the ball.
It's a very hard position now for Finland.
So most of the time you
they're in the safety range.
Yeah. This Bayman tried to run a short run, probably 1 yard, but there's a flag.
He's definitely not a running quarterback.
Absolutely no. He's what is called a pocket quarterback.
A pocket quarterback. You put it in the pocket. Definitely. He tried. We appreciate the try, but it wasn't enough for his team right now.
Let's see the flag.
Another flag. A lot of flags today.
Okay, we saw some players that is meaning the false start.
Well, if it's a false start, it's going to be really, really risky.
Let's see.
An interception that is turning into something really, really negative here.
Let's see. The penalty is declined. Okay, so what's going on? There's a flag. Probably
after the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct by the defense, number 78. Penalties half the distance to the goal. Second down.
Okay, so
penalties
was a penalty for the Finnish team. The penalty has been declined by the French team, and the result is a second and 10 from the goal line. So what does it mean? If the quarterback or some Finnish player will be tackled into the end zone,
it's a safety.
That's a safety. That means 2 points on the scoreboard for the French team.
Tries to run again. He did like a couple yards.
Yeah, Bayman is forcing himself to run and to
collect. It's a really painful moment for Bayman. I would put like a wing or something.
Okay.
They try to give the punter more room to pant, but it's a halftime.
It's an halftime, so we will be able on the scoreboard is 0-0, and we.
qualunque oggetto, anche il più piccolo, può diventare un serio pericolo se usato in una maniera sbagliata. Sono più di 36.000 gli incidenti causati dalla distrazione. Mandare un semplice messaggio o rispondere a un'email mentre stai guidando l'auto può mettere in pericolo la tua vita e quella di chi ti circonda. Quando guidi, guida e basta.
Ecco Elena che lotta per l'ambiente, per la biodiversità, per un sistema di produzione sostenibile che rispetti la terra e chi la lavora. Perché il mondo si cambia con le scelte di ogni giorno. Alce Nero, agricoltori biologici dal 1978.
Diversi terreni, diverse condizioni e difficoltà non ci fermano. Una vera squadra è quella che si mette in gioco, quella dove si combatte, non ci si arrende, dove si suda, per farci trovare pronti alle sfide del futuro. Quando cresci, lo fai con la squadra, fianco a fianco, insieme. Insieme è perfetto.
RDS insieme a te. Voglia di grandi eventi.
qualunque oggetto, anche il più comune, può diventare un serio pericolo se usato in una maniera sbagliata. Sono più di 36.000 gli incidenti causati dalla distrazione. Mandare un semplice messaggio o rispondere a un'email mentre stai guidando l'auto può mettere in pericolo la tua vita e quella di chi ti circonda. Quando guidi, guida e basta.
Ecco Elena che lotta per l'ambiente, per la biodiversità, per un sistema di produzione sostenibile che rispetti la terra e chi la lavora. Perché il mondo si cambia con le scelte di ogni giorno. Alce Nero, agricoltori biologici dal 1978.
Diversi terreni, diverse condizioni e difficoltà non ci fermano. Una vera squadra è quella che si mette in gioco, quella dove si combatte, non ci si arrende, dove si suda per farci trovare pronti alle sfide del futuro. Quando cresci, lo fai con la squadra, fianco a fianco, insieme. Insieme è perfetto.
RDS insieme a te. Voglia di grandi eventi.
So welcome back to all of our friends to the Lunetta Gamberini in Bernardi Field here in Bologna for the second half of French-Finland, the first game of the European Championship under 19. Right now the two team is back on the field and the score is very easy, 0-0. We have had the first half of the game in which the special teams basically made the difference, respect the offensive line of each teams. We have had several punts play. Some statistics from the halftime. We have, starting with the Finland. We have the Barrow as a leading rusher with the four rush for 9 yards. On the receiving side, the top receiver is Sara Jarvi with two catches for 12 yards. And on the French side, the leading rusher is Lahid Cyril with six rushes for 33 yards gain. And on the receiving side, Haït Zaidi is one receiver for 8 yards. It confirms basically what we saw in this first half. So basically a lot of passing games from Finland.
Yeah, and a lot of running game for our friends. Both of them can't really take the lead with their offenses, and it's going to be interesting to see what the coaches planned for this second half.
Yeah, because Finland collect 40 yards overall with passing games, while French collect 77 yards with the running games. So now the Finland Finnish team is ready for the kickoff on the 35 yards. Let's see the kick. And the kick is a low kick, long low kick, And number 14, Jonas Bernier, the kicker returner, miss the catch. And let's see.
It's probably going to be ruled as an outside ball.
Probably. And let's back on. Let's say on the.
There's no foul on the play.
Okay.
For a kick out of bounds because the player touched the ball first.
Okay. No fault because the player touched the ball, and so we will start from the 15 yards in the French territories.
That's not the best way to start for the French team. So
yep.
We'll see what they got to try to advance with their offense. Probably a run.
Yeah, but now we see in the field the quarterback, Leo Kramades, class 2001. So 18 years old. We have one receiver on the left, one on the right, and one running back. It's a run made by number 34 with just 26 is the runner, and the gain is approximately 1 yard. So we will have a second and 9.
So Bacanti Poulin Yanis tried to advance, but he couldn't break through the defense that is still very active and very ready to stop the power football of the Team France.
So Kremades, another run play. Another yard collected with this run, and will be a 3rd and 8. So we see French that continue to invest their efforts in the running game, but till now the result is a little bit poor, just 2 yards in three plays.
It's always the same fakes and the same plays. I hope they have something new in store for us.
Yeah, it's like they continue to make the run game, just waiting a mistake from the Finnish defense.
Ooh, nice run by number 30.
That is running. On the 50, on the 30, on the 30, on the 25 yards. And it's good. It's a huge run made by the number 30, Keita Redval. It was a powerful run, and now the ball is on a 25 yards in the Finland territory.
Keita Redval, incroyable, as the French say. Incredible run. He ran for his life right now. He really ran for his life, and what an amazing run.
Wow. Now the ball is on a 23 yards. As we were saying, the French still invest in the running game, waiting for mistakes from the Finnish defense. And this is what happened. There's another run.
Nice run by number 40, who is trying to come through the defense. And he did a really good run for a fullback of his size. Monduc Florian, incredible run.
Yeah, and it was been able to collect 6 yards, and now we are on the 2nd and 4.
That's what they need.
17. He's on the 18 yards. There's another run.
By 34 this time. So the inside rushes don't really work for number 34 anymore. The defense of Finland is really well trained against him. But I think that if they give the ball to any other running back, it's going to be better. With Redval, that's what they did.
Yeah, I agree. Now we have a 3rd and 3 for the French team.
It's an important play right here.
Yeah.
They feel the pressure.
Let's see what's going on. 28 in motion. There's another run. But now the Finnish defense keep the runner.
Well, actually, 34 did a great job following his box, but they collapsed, unfortunately.
Yeah, the offensive line collapsed and allows the defense of the Finnish team to tackle the running back. And now, for the first time, we will see the special team with the field goal option. So the number 23, Clément Chevalier. And now it's a timeout from France.
Do we
timeout, France.
Do
first
we expect a trick play from a field goal formation?
Wow.
I don't think so.
Well, considering that the French show us a very traditional plays till now, I do not expect any trick play or fake field goal. And be honest, the opportunity to put 3 points on the scoreboard
is
very
everything right now. This can very can make the difference in this game. It has been a 0-0 till here, so 3 points are what they have been looking for forever.
Yeah, especially for a game in which the defense made a huge game for both sides. So let's see what's going on right now. Clément Chevalier ready for the kick. So let's see. The snap is good. The kick
is bad.
Good. And the kick
it's
is good.
From here, I couldn't see it.
Chevalier. A kick a little bit shorter, but long enough to
nice.
Put 3 points on the scoreboard. And now French lead 3-0 against Finland.
Superbe, as the French say. Incredible performance by Chevalier. He is the hero of his team right now.
Yeah, good play made by French. And now, I think that with 9 minutes more or less remaining for this third quarter, the Finland probably what they will try to come back as soon as they can in the end zone of the French team. Chevalier, after this successful kick, now is ready for the kickoff. For the kick return.
The special teams make a really big difference in this game. We'll see if Finland would take the opportunity to make a difference right here in this play.
You see, the kick is good. Very long
and
nine.
By number 24 from Finland.
Let's see the return.
Who is breaking a couple tackles, but it's being stopped.
Stopped by the number, by the number 10.
24.
Paul Meunier on the 23 yards.
And it was Arttu Kettunen for Finland on the 22 yards.
So let's see now, Byman. Taking the lead of his offensive team.
Ow.
And let's see if they, wow, spread formation, but probably is an illegal formation, I guess.
I think the Finland team wasn't ready.
Let's see.
False start. By the offense, never got set. 5 yard penalty.
These mistakes, man, they make the game, you know? Who makes less mistakes wins the game, and in this case, it's truer than ever.
Yeah, Byman, I do not understand why Byman decided to press, to hurry up the game in this way.
Especially now, it's
especially in the first down. Let's see, Byman, the pocket, the launch, the ball. Is it incomplete? So the be honest, the pass looked good.
But we have a new quarterback in Finland. It's Jesper Korkalainen. And he's, I think he's testing his teammates right now, and he's testing his receivers.
So the number 11, the new QB.
It's a run.
It's a run QB. Let's see.
Pass.
Wow.
This QB runs.
And runs well, because he ran for more than 10 years and he was able to
move the chain.
Not move the chain, but we have a third and three, I guess.
Just hit the chain.
Just hit the chain, yeah. But he ran outside the field on the sideline, and but was the run was good, and now we have a 3 and 4, I guess. Another pass.
Too short for the finished quarterback. So now we have a running quarterback and a passing team. So we'll see what happens.
Let's see.
But it's a punt. The punt game.
The number one, Alexi Pulkkinen, ready for the punt. We have a 4 and 3, ready for the punt. The snap is quite good. Whoa,
and
the punt is blocked
by France. Wow. That stops the ball, and
what a play.
First down for France, number 84.
The number 84, Terence Manigold, finalized the good job made by the punt blocker.
Manigold in Italian can be translated by golden hands.
Yeah.
So that's what he did with his golden hand. He just received the ball at the right time.
And in this case, they are very golden hands.
Exactly.
Because they, you know, made this turnover. They basically took the ball in the Finland territory on the 30 yards.
It's a special teams game.
Yeah, you said before, and it's true. And the flag game also, because we have another flag.
Full start. Offense, number 26, 5-yard penalty.
All these motions are really, really dangerous for the offense of the French team.
Matteo Colomba back in the field. It's interesting to see how French is switching the quarterback, but basically the playbook remained the same. They continue to
run the ball.
Run the ball.
Number 26 again.
And we have a 2 yards run for the number 26.
Back on Tipo Lajeris. We're changing running back. Number 34 is back in the game. And he's the one that all the defensive line of the Finnish team is hungry for.
Back in the field, Cyril Lahiba with 33 yards rushed in the first half time.
He's ready.
Let's see. Good run. Forcing the defensive line of a Finnish team.
Now it's time for a pass ball.
And it's a 3rd and 11 for the French team. Now we will see. We will see if they want to close the down or just collect the enough yards to try another field goal. Because we saw that Clement is able to cover this kind of distance. Colomba, ball in the air, but
it's a flag.
There's a flag.
Interference from the Finnish team, Finnish defense. Definitely an interference.
Pretty obvious.
But see, they're underestimating the receivers. That's what I was saying before. Now they're throwing the ball, and I think they're able to do a passing game that will work.
Pass interference by the defense, number 20, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Wow, 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 what a painful flag for Finland, because right now they have the first down, so from the 17 yards, and of course in the field goal, in the field goal range.
And it's going to be a run by 26, who breaks the defense.
The tackle, he breaks basically three tackles.
Pretty good gain for an inside rush like that.
Yeah.
On a first down.
Let's see, should be around 4 yards. And now we have a second and six. Colombo. The pocket. Let's see, is another rush.
Number 26 again.
There's no space to run. The defense line collapse over the number 26 on the number 26.
The defense is crunching inside a lot, and they're narrowing every possibility for the running backs to run inside. So I think it's time for France to spread out a little bit and throw a ball or throw a pitch to someone and do a nice switch.
I agree, and let's see with this third down and five, but there's another inside run, and the number 7-7 is a monster. It takes down the number 26. So
but we're in field goal range again.
Yeah.
So maybe Chevalier will definitely surprise us with his kicks.
Let's see Chevalier entering in the team is a four down, ready for the field goal. Chevalier is ready.
Number 23, like Jordan.
Let's see. Snap is good. The kick is blocked, but there's a flag. There's a flag.
There's a flag
on the field. Let's see. Probably an early movement by the defense.
On the center, maybe.
Let's see if an offside by the defense.
Yeah, I think they...
offside, defense, number
wow,
28.
Wow, it's painful because a five-yard penalty means the first down.
They moved on the center right away.
And the chain is moving. Let's see.
Maybe they're too close.
Oh, they do not close it down. But it's 4-1. And France changed their mind.
Absolutely, I think they're not gonna kick now, of course.
No,
but they're gonna.
I mean, they have all the skills and capabilities to cover 1 yard with an easy rush game. Let's see what's going on.
I would play a power instead of an inside, like inside rush. A nice
Let's
power.
See.
And it's.
It's good, but there's a flag.
Holding by the defense.
Let's see. What the ref will call.
Holding by the offense, number 84.
Offense.
10-yard penalty.
So
first down.
Let's back 10 yards, and now we have a 4-11, and now let's see.
That's a different story.
What's going on? We are always in the field goal range.
Definitely.
So Chevalier could enter.
Chevalier will step up, I think.
Okay, let's see what's going on. From my point of view, this will be an opportunity for Chevalier. But let's see what the head coach of the French team will call.
That's a very important call, right?
Colombe is still in the field. Looks like they want to play. Looks like they want to play it. They're going to play.
I would, at this point, it's like now or never, all in or nothing. I would just like throw the ball. Just like they did before with the holding, the interference.
Yeah, my point of view, I will put other 3 points in the bank, to be honest.
I know, but at this point, if they're going to play it, just throw the damn ball.
Let's see. In fact, now there's a timeout for French. They want to think a little bit more about it.
Timeout.
And let's see what's going on.
Second timeout.
Okay. Now, the French team is in Adolo, as the Finland team.
Chevalier is talking to the head coach. We can see it from here. I think they're discussing a possibility to kick.
Let's see what's going on.
But I think he's going to keep his decision.
Of course, for it's a thrilling moment of the game. And as it happens in the first, in the half time and in the previous part of the game, French spent 2 of 3 timeouts in this first quarter of the second half. So let's see what's going on. The Finland defense is already on the field, but the French team is still in Nadal. The head coach is providing the last advice about the game that they can play. Let's see what's going on. I would be surprised if they try a pass game.
Me too, but it would be a nice surprise. I think in this moment, you just have to try and be bold. And if you want to be bold till the end, you got to throw the ball.
Okay, let's back. Colombe behind the center, 4-11. Let's see. Should be a pass game. Let's
and
see.
It's a pass.
It's a pass. It's a good pass.
And it's a touchdown. And it's a touchdown by 84. Incredible by Manigold Terence. Manigold with his golden hands. He scored the first France touchdown.
So the first touchdown of the game.
It's a touchdown pass.
It's a touchdown pass. Incredible, I would say.
See? And football is a surprising game, isn't
and
it?
And now on the waiting for the extra point, the scoreboard says French 9, Finland nothing. So French lead 9-0.
Good job by Colombe Matteo too.
Chevalier.
And Chevalier hits.
Kick is good.
Score.
And now. Four. French lead 10-0 against Finland.
They are in flames. They are really inflamed and happy about this result. It's incredible that they scored with the pass, but see, when you need to challenge yourself and go over your limits, this happens. So it's incredible. I love this play. Now everything makes a difference. Finland has to step up their game in offense, especially.
Yeah, I'd be surprised about the Finland defense because you know it was pretty obvious that the French will use a pass game to close the down, and the secondary in this case was not really well positioned in the field.
Even with the interference before, you saw that their cornerbacks are not as skilled as France cornerbacks, I think, and they wouldn't cover number 80 well.
So Chevalier, ready for the kick. The kick is good, long and high.
Number 15 is running.
Is returning and is taken on the 21 by the number 10.
Meunier Paul. Meunier.
Paul Meunier made a good tackle. It allows just a couple of yards, returning yards. And now we will see what's going on. We have the number 11 back. In the field, the Jesper Korkalainen from Taft Vanta that replaced the number 7, Jerry Byman. Wow. No. Now the defense of the French defense is taking the lead against the offensive line of Finland.
I think they're very excited about the
the result.
The performance of the offense. Yeah. Now they want to give them all they got.
Yeah, like say, hey, we are here too.
We're here too, yeah. We will support your score.
So, Jesper.
And it's going to be almost a sack.
Almost sank, but it's an incomplete pass. Thinking about Bayman, probably Bayman when in the first time, I know Bayman is out of the game right now, but probably he took a couple of tackles very hard in the first quarters, and this is why Jesper now replaced him.
Yes, the defense of France made a couple of sacks on
the number seven, Bayman. Jesper. He's looking around for a receiver.
But he's
he's running. He's escaping from.
And it's intercepted. And there's a flag. But it's still a good play by the
Chevalier.
Chevalier.
Wow.
Chevalier is all in right now. He's doing everything. Kicking, intercepting. Number 23 is a lucky number.
Yeah.
Not only for MJ, I think.
Yeah, for sure. Let's talk a little bit about Chevalier. Chevalier, number 23, is 19 years old.
Before the turnover, personal foul, face mask, defense, number 92. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Okay,
that's a very severe and strict penalty. A face mask is always a disaster.
It's a painful penalty.
Any player and any team. So
lucky for Finland. Now they keep the ball. They will start 15 yards ahead of the previous spot. And unfortunately for Chevalier, the ball is in the hands of Finland, and especially in the hands of the number 11, Jesper Korkelainen from Taft-Vanta.
Let's see how they're going to manage this advantage.
So, back on the 38 yards.
And it's a pass again.
It's a pass.
Almost intercepted
Almost intercepted.
The receivers on the Finnish side are playing really with a low energy right now. And I understand if it's for the heat or for the fact that they are being stopped really often. But they have to step up their game if they want to take the lead.
It's obviously difficult to say if in this case is the receiver that make a wrong route or is the QB that make a wrong pass.
The QB that is running now and he's being tackled by Chevalier again. Chevalier that is everywhere in this game.
So let's see, now we have a third down and a three for the Finland team. And let's see what's going on.
They gotta play smart.
Wow, bad snap.
Bad snap, but the quarterback this time is running.
And this is a first down. So when you have a quarterback that is able also to run.
It changes everything. You create a new line every time and a lot of holes in the defense. And if the quarterback is able to run through them, it's a whole different game.
Yeah, it's what we basically is called a scramble quarterback that is able to pass or to run.
There's a player that is injured, number 53, I think, from France. Jean-André Carbouane that is standing up and walking out of field, so we hope he's going to recover soon.
So now we are entering into the French territory with the first and 10 from the 50 yards. We are in the mid of the field.
The first down for Finland, so we're going to see what they're going to go with.
Standard formation.
It's another pass on the left side for number 10.
This is complete.
Has proven to have good hands for the entire game. Kim Serjärvi. Sorry for the pronunciation again. You all have beautiful names.
Yeah, this play is a traditional play from the handbook of American football. Very short pass, 5 yard gain. If you do a couple of play like this, you close the down.
He's gonna hit the trips.
Whoa!
But it's intercepted by Chevalier that is on fire.
Chevalier, on the 30, on the 30, on the 20, on the 10.
And it's
an end zone.
Incredible player, incroyable.
Wow.
And he's gonna kick the ball for sure now, I'm sure.
Yeah. He will keep the ball home.
Instrumental player for France. He's definitely one of the MVPs of this game.
Yeah, now they are celebrating. And now the scoreboard says that France leads 17-0 against Finland, waiting for the extra point. Basically, we should wait for Chevalier for the extra point.
Exactly, he's like putting on his helmet again.
Okay, in fact, now the special team is ready and there's another kicker.
A backup kicker. Okay. Number 80. Number 80 is ready for the kick.
Niels Tarui. The left foot kicker. And the kick
and
is blocked.
That's a really, really bad spot to recover a ball right there.
Okay, let's see.
So they recovered the ball in a very, very bad spot, but we are ready.
So. We are 1 minute 30 seconds to the end of the third quarter. And, I'm surprising about this quarter. After the first two quarters, let me say, very dominated by the defense team. Now we are see two teams that are playing football, especially France.
It's still a defensive game because Chevalier was in defense and he played incredibly and intercepted the ball. But yes, we are seeing France playing with a whole different energy, and they are very motivated and very determined to take this game home and take this win.
So Anis Tarawi
is kicking.
Let's see. And the kick is not so good. Is a
number 43.
Wow, good run. Good
very
return.
Good return for 45 yards. To start on the 45 yards, the Finnish team will start in offense for first down.
It's Willie Lindford from the Helsinki Wolverines that he made this return. Very interesting return. And now the Finnish team will start from the 45 yards.
And Jesper is ready to throw another pass. But no, it's a run.
It's a Kubi run.
And he keeps the ball, but nobody notices.
Yeah, it's a good run. Close the down and more. So we approximately 18 yards rush for Jesper.
What an amazing fake by Jesper. An amazing fake. Nobody in the defense noticed that he took the ball.
No, in fact, the defense, the French defense were looking for the running back, but Jesper hide the ball very well.
And it's a pass again for number 10.
And it's a complete pass.
Kim Serjärvi that is receiving everything tonight.
It was not an easy catch, so. What a catch for the number 10 of the Finland team. And we have a second down, second and five.
It's a run by number 4. What a powerful run by Nico Barrow.
Nico Barro ran for approximately 4 yards, and now we are third and one. So third and one. Let's see. It's another run, but
that's
this time.
A bad read by the quarterback that gives away the ball when he should have kept it.
Number 78, number Olivier Guillen.
Incredible play by the defensive end, but it's a really bad read for Jasper.
Tackle for loss for Guillen. And the loss was around 3 yards, so we have a 4 and 4. What's going on?
Timeout.
Timeout.
Before the snap. Timeout. Team France, it's the third and final timeout.
It's a very important and pivotal play for France right now, so I understand the timeout calling. They have to adjust well to this fourth down.
Okay, I agree, but you would call the timeout even if it's your last timeout.
Maybe
we are still
right.
in the middle of the third quarter.
You're right. It's not the smartest decision, but considering how they have been playing, the France team is playing, I think that it's a good call. I mean, on the fourth down before or a third down, they intercepted the ball and just took it home for a touchdown. So maybe they can surprise us here too.
No, they feel very confident about how the game is going.
Chevalier is in the game. Free safety, sees everything.
So,
and it's another pass for Jasper.
Wow,
and it's
almost intercepted.
So, great job here by
Jonas Bernier.
By the cornerbacks, the cornerback gang of France. They are really, really powerful against the Finnish.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Fourth quarter.
Okay, so we are in the fourth quarter right now. And starting this last quarter, French is leading 16-0 against Finland.
Wow. So that's really interesting how this
two possession means. This means two possession for Finland if they wanted to.
Exactly. So we'll see what France has in store. It's the fourth quarter. We're changing. We're switching the fields.
Switching the field, ball in the hands of the French team, and especially in the hands of Léo Crémadet. Léo Crémadet, now we will start.
They look like a brand new team. They have more energy, they are pumped. It's time to run again, and it's gonna be
it's a super run on the 50,
27.
On the 40, on the 30, on the 27 yards.
Incredible run
by the number 27, Adrien Clicquot. Adrien Clicquot made a powerful run. And
that's a statement play right there. He made a statement. It was like, this is my territory now. We are gonna score again. That's what he said with this play.
Yeah, Olivier André Clicquot is 18 years old from South Fighters.
And first now down for France.
First down for France from the 27 yards.
And Finland it's a run by 26. Pretty good run in the middle.
And the 4 yards gain, now we'll have a second and six. Second and six for the French team that now is starting, or we will start also to play with the clock.
Exactly, so we see now that all their runs have a meaning. And now the clock will be ticking very fast.
Considering that the French team, full start probably.
That's a full start right there.
Full start. Yeah. Three flags on the play just to say false start. Anyway,
they like the false flag.
Yeah,
I would do it too if I
false start. Offense number 59, 5-yard penalty.
Anyway, considering that the French prefer rush game, running game, now that they have also to manage the clock, I think that we will basically see running game from French team.
It's interesting how they are playing. By the end of the game, they're being more synchronized. Everything is being more fluid. Even if they're tired, it gets better and better because they have been practicing the entire game together.
Yeah. Not very performing run right now.
But the inside rush is not the best way to play against the Finnish defense. Even if it's the end of the game, they are still really dominant on the line.
That's true. That's a good analysis. And now we have a 3rd and 11. Leo Clemade.
Too many motions. They're losing a focus right now.
I think that they lost around 80, 90 yards today.
By the offense,
of them are from
5-yard penalty.
Full start due to this incredible motion.
They have to fix that for their next games for sure. These penalties are a shame because they're really like lose a focus. It's not by mistake. It's literally because you're not concentrated enough.
Yeah.
It's hard to feel the pressure to be at a European competition. So that's true, but they have to adjust to that for sure.
Another motion.
And
is another run.
Another run by 26 in the middle. I think they need to change some of that strategy because running with the same run and making the same poles all the time is not going to help anyone.
Let's say that it's useful just for the clock.
Exactly.
Now is a 4 and long for French. Chevalier is in the field. Now let's see if it's in a field goal range. No, it's a punt.
They're punting.
Let's see.
A little push punt for Chevalier.
Okay. No, out of the field.
Out of the field.
That's a very good punt. That's a very nice one, which will fill up in a very difficult position.
Let's see.
So it was not a very nice, very beautiful kick, but it was very.
Oh, for the 1 yard. Okay, so it was a very interesting punt from Chevalier, and now their Finnish team will start from their own 1 yard in a safety range, let's say. Let's see what's going on. Finland changed the quarterback, and it's the interception. Interception from the 98.
And it's a touchdown for France because they stopped the ball and recovered it in a touchdown. This French team is full of surprises tonight.
So what's going on? The Finland team changed for the third time the quarterback, Ambro Uriarsson.
There's a flag. Also, the referees are trying to surprise us tonight.
There's a flag. Let's see what's going on. Anyway, the Finland team changed the quarterback for the third time. Now we have the number 12, that is Ambro Uriarsson.
Not the best time to change the quarterback.
No. Ambro basically threw a pass, but it has been intercepted by the number 98, Christopher Fontenard. And after the interception, he made the touchdown.
The officials are talking, let's say.
After the play was over,
unsportsmanlike conduct
against the offense, team foul. Penalty is 15 yards enforced on the kickoff. The score is good.
Okay. So
the score is good. Chevalier is about to hit the ball again with this very powerful kick. Let's see what happens.
So now the scoreboard says that France lead 22-0 against Finland, waiting for Chevalier for the extra point. The penalties will be applied after the kick.
And it's good.
The kick is good.
And the kick is good for Chevalier, an incredible player tonight.
23-0, French is leading this game. And even if we are at the beginning of the fourth quarter, probably the Finland is starting to think about
their mistakes tonight and all the little mistakes, really, the little details that matter and that change the game, especially the game of football.
Be honest, from my point of view, the lack of this Finland team is the offense.
Yes, it's not synchronized at all. They have a great passing game, but it's not consistent.
Exactly.
And they need that consistency. So let's see what happens in the last moments of this game. And we are ready to see another performance by the special teams that have been really important tonight. Sometimes they're underestimated, you know, the special teams, but they can really change a game, especially when the defenses are so powerful, like in this one.
Anyway, now the ball is on a 20 yards on the French territory. Chevalier ready for the kick. Waiting for the whistle.
Chevalier is everywhere tonight.
Probably the most valuable player.
Pretty good, but he went out, so. Oh, and there's a flag.
The flag. Probably against the kicking team. Against.
They're gonna kick again right now.
That we'll see.
They kick again.
Free kick out of bounds by the kicking team. The ball will be placed on the 35 yard line. First down wide.
Okay, it's a first down wide then.
On the 35.
So they take the penalty and they're going to start with 5 yards penalty.
Correction. The free kick wasn't taken from the 35, so the ball will be placed on the 50 yard line. First down.
Okay, ball on the 50 yards.
That's a pretty good spot to start, I'd say.
Yeah.
Let's
but
see what they have in store. Because I think that their passing game now is pretty much very stoppable by the French team.
Let's see what's going on with Ambro Urjanso, 17
it's
years
a balanced,
old.
Balanced formation. Number 88 just received the ball. Pretty good catch, but pretty good tackle by the French defense.
So from Helsinki Roosters, Ambro Uriarsson, 17 years old.
Probably one of the youngest
players.
It's a throw again, but this time is too short for the quarterback.
Yeah.
And too short for number 88 to catch it. So
as we said before, when you know do not have accuracy and you're not precise, you can have good players in the field, but
it's hard when you're you just got in the game. And you know, everybody in France, like in the French team, scored 23-0.
Yeah.
So it's hard.
So 3-6. Ambro tried to run, but collapsed under the tackles of the defensive line of the French team. So we will see
a 4th and 7 here for Finland. It isn't going well. Yeah. Maybe they have to start running the ball a little more and surprise the French defense that it's completely spread out right now and is only waiting for passes.
So let's see. They're playing this 4 and down.
And it's a pass
it's a pass. It's a good pass.
86.
Completed.
And it's a first down for Finland. Very surprising. This catch by 86, Christian Ristila, And great pass, though.
Great pass.
The quarterback was in a lot of pressure, but he found a way to hit his receiver.
Yeah, he made this pass. He made this pass running and also looking for some takers for from French defense.
And it's another pass, but it's
out of bounds. Anyway, so we will have a second and 10 from the 32 yards.
Is one of his favorite targets.
Yeah.
That's not good to have favorite targets. you are predictable. And it's a good pass for number 10.
And there's another completed down.
Another first down for Finland. And another catch for Kim Seri Jarvi that has been the best receiver of the Finland team tonight.
Yeah, and the number 10, Kim Sharjarvi, is a teammate of Ambro because they played both on the Helsinki Roosters. So now
we have trips left for Finland. And there's a run for number 34, but it's not effective.
No, just probably 1 yard.
Palmi doesn't go a long way. But
there's a flag. There's a flag.
Maybe a face mask. Maybe not. We'll see.
Against the offense, I guess. Probably an holding.
They're advancing pretty well, so it would be a shame.
Let's see.
See the decision of the ref.
I would bet for an holding.
That's the best bet, maybe.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct by the defense, number 53.
Wow.
Penalty will be half the distance to the goal, first down.
Wow.
Half the distance
to the goal. We don't like this kind of falls, but it happens sometimes. So, but you get punished pretty hardly. So
yeah.
Here we are. And there's a chance for Finland now.
For the first time, the Finland is entering the red zone.
Let's see what the quarterback can work.
Ambro.
His magic. But the cornerbacks are really, really...
A very risky pass.
I think they realize that his favorite targets are 86 number 10. So now they're very putting pressure on these two receivers.
Now we throw the ball in the middle of a lot of blue jerseys. So very risky pass.
I would run if I were him. Like, they don't expect a run for the quarterback anymore.
Especially when you are 9 yards from the end zone.
Ooh,
it's a good run. It's a good run.
34.
Wow,
that,
let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 blue jersey. Ready to take all the number 34.
He needed to take some vertical space, but he preferred to go horizontal, and he was tackled like hardly by
if you are not able to find the right space between the line,
it's counterproductive.
Yeah,
and it's a pass again, but there's a sack by number 52 of France, an incredible sack.
Arnaud Bourquel
that that's a big play, big time play right there. We needed, I mean, the French team needed this play.
And let's see what now, because now you need a big play. It's a 4 and a super long. You need a big play, the ball in the air, very. Let's see what's going on, but in the middle of nothing. In the middle of nothing. And this is another turnover. So good play made by the defense of the French team that after the sank will push back the offensive line of the Finland team. And
this
now
defense, man, they are really, really hard on the Finnish team, and they made the difference tonight. You know how they say the offense sells the tickets and the defense wins the games, and in this case is truer than ever.
So 3 minutes and 45 seconds to the end of this fantastic game where the French is leading 23-0 against Finland. Now another run game for the French. Probably the team was not very well prepared. And then basically they lose 1 yard. Now we have a 2 and 11, but the time is clocking, and it's not an issue for the French that now they really invest all the time they have to prepare the next play. So we have 3 minutes and 30 to play. Is it a run? Is a good run. The number 26 broke a couple of tackle. Now was an inside rush with a gain of 2/3 yards, no more than that, being done by the number 26, Yanis Bocanti-Paulin. And now, Clémadier. Is ready to play another game. Third and nine. Clémad. It's good pass.
Ooh,
and then the
pass.
Number 26 is
number
running
26.
In the Finland territory.
Incredible catch by number 26.
38
so.
Yards. And Yanis Bocanti-Paulin was with a very good run. Now they are in the Finland territory, and the clock is ticking. Cremade. Inado. Prima de Inado. So will be another run game, probably. We have the fullback ready to take the ball. And this is a run made by the number 40, Florian Mondu. And he gained 6 yards. And now we have a second and four. Second and four for from the 33 yards. The French team now is just thinking how to manage the ball without doing any mistake in order to keep the scoreboard 23-0. Another motion. Oh, this is painful for the French time, for the French team. They lost a lot of
false start.
They lost a lot
by the
of
offense,
yards.
Number 74, 5 yard penalty. Second down.
Probably for the next game, they should invest a little bit more attention on these motions, because they really received against 6-7 flags for this early motion. Now, Clémadier. Another motion, another run play for the fullback, number 40, Florian Mondu, and the down is closed. So we will have a first down starting from the 26 yards. So talking with all of our friends that are following our game, talking about the most valuable players, please write down what are from you your most valuable player of the game? We accept all your suggestions. is another run made at number 26. Wow. Six yards collected by the number 26, Yanis. And now we have a second and four to play. We are very close to the 2 minutes warning.
And we're very close to the end zone too. So it's a run by number 27. Taking the first down and more.
Yeah, he made a good run. Also, he used very well the block offered by the left guard of the French team. And now we have a first down from the 10 yards. So we are entering into the red zone. Two minutes, 25 seconds to go.
In the stands, they are screaming, c'est pas fini, it's not over. So they want France to score again, even if it's the last minute.
Okay.
This is a 2 minute warning.
2 minutes warning.
2 minutes.
Okay. So we will back after the 2 minutes warning from the with the first down, first and goal from the French team. The scoreboard says French leads 23-0 against Finland. We saw a very good team play very good football, especially the defense.
There's another run
made at number 27. Adrien Clicquot.
Very nice run to make the clock run.
Yeah.
I think the best players of this team, this game for me, for what concerns me, I think it would be Chevalier and number 10 of Finland.
The number 10 of Finland is Kim Shariarvi.
He catched everything he could catch and did a lot of good plays. But let's see the second down for France. And it's another run for number 30. That scores again. Incredible run, an incredible sweep, and great block by Keita Redval. We saw great runs from him for the entire game. He ran for his life, and now it's Chevalier's turn to put the ball in.
So we're looking for some comments from our friends that is following this game. There are some comments that are in line with yours. So Chevalier MVP, but also Florian Mondu and Yanis Paulin.
It's a team effort, let's say. Yeah. I would give the MVP to every running back for this game for sure.
Exactly. Thank you to all of our friends that will contribute with your suggestion. Now the extra point is good, and the scoreboard says French 29, Finland nothing. And when we have 1 minute, 10 seconds to go, so we are almost close to the end of the game. What can I say? The French team show his capabilities and skills to play a nice European Championship. Their strategy to play most of the run games paid very well, because the scoreboard says 30-0. Probably they should pay attention a little bit more about the early motion, because they collect a lot of flags and penalties that when you are playing other match, like for example semifinals or finals, could cost you a lot. But now Chevalier, another kick, another interesting kick, very long and high. And the returning team from Finland is made by the number 43, Willy Linford from Helsinki Wolverines. Finland, we will start from the 34 yards. And probably we will see for the last time the defense of the French team in the field, because the clock is less than 1 minute. Ambro with the long pass. Wow! Was a great play. It was an incomplete pass. Yeah, but nice cover made by Paul Meunier. And the receiver, the target receiver, was Capo Perakumpu. But it was an incomplete pass. So Ambro is moving outside the pocket.
On the right side.
The pass.
It's not caught, it's not good.
Probably it's an incomplete pass. The target was always the number two, Capo Perakumpu, but the pass was too low, and the ball hit the ground because the receiver had the opportunity to catch the ball. So it's an incomplete pass, and we have a third and 10. Ambro.
He's ready to pass again. For his right side this time, but I don't know. He's gonna
another pass.
And it's intercepted.
It was almost intercepted by the number 51, Stéphane Cardin.
Incredible how France is playing till the last play, leaving everything on the field and trying to catch other opportunities to score. That's the football I like to watch.
Yeah. When you have a consistent defense like the French has, I mean, you can also try adopt offensive gameplay like a small run, as we saw for the long
Absolutely.
Part of the game, because you are sure that no one would put points on the scoreboard.
It's another pass, but it's out of bounds.
And we have a turnover. Probably this is the last turnover of the game.
Let's see if the French
could take a knee. I would take a knee.
Yes, it's their first game of this competition. Maybe nobody has to get hurt, and I will.
I would take a knee, also to respect the Finland that made a great play, good defense.
I think that as a player, you prefer to play every little and last play, like you don't like this all respect thing.
Yeah.
You just want to play till the end.
Anyway, they would take a knee.
Try to steal the ball, but yeah.
Okay, let's see. Congratulations to the French team on their first game of this European Championship. They won 30-0 against a good Finland team. Especially on the defense side, probably that the Finland missed something in their offensive playbook.
Yes, we saw great defense at first. They made a lot of mistakes in the second half, but I think they can maybe recover against another team and maybe improve their offense a little bit more, because they're not going anywhere with all passes.
I agree.
Offense, especially if it's not consistent.
I agree.
And with the teams in the middle of the field, I think they are going to be awarded. The players are going to be awarded after this final handshakes. For what it concerns me, I think Chevalier would be the MVP for the French team, no doubt. And for the Finland team, who knows, but maybe number 10 that demonstrated a really, really consistent path of catching the ball for every quarterback that we saw for Finland.
Yeah, I'll be honest, I really like the number 11 of Finland, the quarterback. Remember Jesper, because I was a consistent player, quarterback, both in the past game, but also
running
a running game. I would like to know what happened to the number seven, Jared Bynum, because he never see the field anymore after the first half. Probably he's been tackled very hardly.
I think that it's interesting how they keep changing. Every game is going to be different, and they're going to change the quarterbacks again. It's the MVP moment for both teams. They're going to announce the MVPs.
Let's see. Let's see the MVP. Let's see if our friends that follow us today suggested well. Okay.
Everybody's so very proud of him. I think they did the right thing. He played an amazing game and he was everywhere tonight.
Okay, so Chevalier, most valuable player of the game, is from the French side.
It's really funny to see the emotions of the guys. They're really very excited. This is the reason why we all play football.
Let's see.
Oh, this is amazing. This is what I live for. Everybody is really happy for him, and he totally deserved it. Totally deserved it. I wonder how Finland is going to take their MVP and who's going to be.
That's a ceremony. Don't worry. We have time to 9 o'clock.
Okay.
So,
and for...
For Finland, let's see.
The offense, the most valuable player for Finland has been named number 10, Kim Saar-Järvi.
Kim Saar-Järvi.
I think he wasn't expecting it at all.
Yeah, for sure. Saar-Järvi today catch four balls for 32 yards. And it has been the most productive player for Finland.
And they're not very excited, but I think it's for the loss.
Personal satisfaction, but I think that Kim probably preferred to win the game without taking any recognition. So it's time to go. I want to say thank you to all of our friends. Thank you from Matteo Mangione and Nausicaa Dell'Orto.
And we will start again our comment of the game, of the next game at 9 o'clock. We're going to see you again on this channel for the game of Sweden against Norway.
Exactly.
So thank you very much for following us in this journey. And sorry if it misspelled every name in the list, but in the name of football, we say goodbye to you and thank you.
Bye.